19-year-old student Patrick Harrington is a member of the National Front, and following a left-wing campaign against him and demonstrations against his presence in the Polytechnic of North London, he obtained a High Court order last week forbidding interference with his studies. But when Mr. Harrington entered the Polytechnic building in Kentish Town this afternoon for his first lecture of the summer term, he found his way barred.
I gave a copy of the court order to the pickets, them to look at. They ripped the court order up, and I think that sums up their attitude to the law in general. I'm now going to go over and speak to the police about this matter and ask them if there is any assistance that they can offer me.
But the police could not enter the Polytechnic to enforce the High Court order and allow Mr. Harrington to study because the Polytechnic authorities did not give permission to enter the building, so the demonstration continued.
We are going to continue to keep Harrington out of this Polytechnic, yeah.
Why?
He's a Nazi.
He's a leading National Front member. And he's not just the, you know, disaffiliated youth flirting with National Front politics. He's a committed Nazi. He's associate editor of National Front News. He's published South London News, which held the first hit lists. He's a threat, he's a danger, and we don't want him here.
The demonstration soon spilled out of the Polytechnic building onto the pavement and the road. Tempers flared after police tried to protect a companion of Mr. Harrington's who'd taken pictures of the demonstrators. 20 minutes later, and after Patrick Harrington had left, police reinforcements arrived and made 4 arrests. Officials at the Polytechnic refused to comment on today's incident, although yesterday they issued all 7,000 students at the Polytechnic of North London with a letter advising them not to flout the court order obtained by Mr. Harrington. He intends to return to court to pursue his case, so the dispute looks set to continue for some time yet. Ros Morris in Kentish Town for Thames News.